welcome back to World Mechanics. If you guys have a Chevy Cruze, guys, or Chevy Sonic, and you guys experiencing coolant in your oil, or oil, guys, in your coolant, any of the two situations, guys, stay with us, we will explain what causes that. Now, that same engine, guys, it is used on Chevy Cruze and Chevy Sonic. That's why we are including both vehicles, guys, and we will be making more than 200 videos on these cars. So please, guys, subscribe to the channel. Our goal is to save you guys as much money as we can, and when you in return, subscribe to the channel, like the video, and drop a comment below. Now, this is, guys, the Chevy Cruze I'm talking about. Let me first remove the bumper, and I'm going to explain a few things to you. Why you may have oil in your coolant and or coolant in your oil, guys. Any of the two situations. So, let me explain to you quick. So, this is, guys, okay, 2015 Cruze, but it should be the same for the whole generation with a 1.8 engine. I think it will work for the 1.4 as well. The only place, guys, okay, you have two hypothetical situations why you can have coolant in your oil or oil in your coolant. Okay, the first one that's not so common is having a bad head gasket. Having a bad head gasket, guys, you can mix coolant and oil pretty easy because the head gasket, the canals for the oil and the coolant are next to each other, and if the gasket is leaking, they can mix. So that's something that could happen, but it's not very common unless the car was overheated. But if you guys have a higher miles car and you experience something like that, let me, guys, explain to you why you can experience coolant in your oil and the other way around. So this is, guys, your oil engine oil cooler. Okay, right here. This one is actually located behind the catalytic converter. The whole video, guys, from start to finish, is on our main channel. Check it out. Auto Repair, guys, is our main channel. The video will be there. It probably will take you about 30 to 40 minutes to do the job, but you'll be able to remove the catalytic converter and get to the oil cooler, which is located, okay, on the block right here. This is one of the gaskets, oil gaskets. This is the other one there. However, guys, okay, you can see only oil goes through this gasket. So where you can actually develop that problem to mix coolant and oil? Let me show you now. We're going to, guys, okay, remove these bolts here with the Torx 30. Six bolts that we need to remove. And I will show you, guys, what problem we have here. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bolts. When I pull that thing off, guys, you have two gaskets here, okay, right? Two gaskets, and you're going to notice, okay, that this is an oil gasket, okay, this is where the oil goes through from one side to the other one, and this is the cooler for the oil here, and the other gasket, guys, this is actually a coolant gasket. Entrance and exit. Okay, so these gaskets, guys, they're next to each other. Okay, as you can see, next to each other. And as a result, guys, okay, being next to each other, if both of them start leaking, okay, you can develop having a coolant in your oil or the other way around. Or the other most common reason is a bad oil cooler. Inside, if something cracks, okay, they will mix. So those are, guys, the top three reasons. So once you, guys, remove, okay, the side of the engine here, we have an oil pump assembly here and the timing cover. You can see there is actually a place where on some cars you have a gasket here, coolant will flow, oil will flow, and if that coolant gasket fails, the coolant will go in the oil pan and you will mix coolant and oil in the oil pan. If you lose those gaskets, you can even experience, guys, decreased oil pressure as well. That's another reason. So hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to some of you. Please, guys, hit that subscribe button for more videos, and see you guys next time.